Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I hope you can see me clearly. And today I'll be talking about something important that we all need in our lives, that we all need to be practicing. It's very important. And what is that about? So I'm talking about Thanksgiving today. Thanksgiving, being grateful, you know, appreciative. And I'm channeling it through faith. What is Thanksgiving? Thanksgiving is a form of, sorry, I'm actually doing this in my office as it was placed in my heart to do it. So you will be hearing some noise in the background because we are not yet done with work today. So Thanksgiving means, to me, I see Thanksgiving as, I understand Thanksgiving as that mood of appreciation, you know, for what someone has done for you, or what someone is yet to do for you, or what somebody is planning to do for you. And now we are channeling this to God. Today, this afternoon, I was just sitting down in the car and I was thinking. I was just like going through round the clock of my thoughts, and it dawned on me like, God has really been merciful to me. God has really shown me so much kindness. God has really shown me so much mercy. And what do I mean by that? For me to be where I am today is just by the grace of God, and it's not like I merit it. It's not like, yes, I deserve it, but here I am today. And there was a song that came to my mind, and it's one of the lines I love so much was, thank you, Lord, for the future I see. I see you doing great things in my future. I see you doing great and mighty things ahead of me. I know that, yes, you will do what you have said you will do. That's why I'm so grateful. I was so happy within me, believing that, yes, something great is ahead of me, something wonderful, something spectacular, something amazing is ahead of me. My family, my children, my husband, my career, my everything. So there's this joy that came on me. I was down. I just stood up and I began to appreciate God. I began to appreciate God. There are many of us right now, the situations we are in, we are almost losing hope. We are almost giving up. We are saying, oh yes, my own is over. God is done with me. There is nothing he can do for me again, because I'm just, you've written yourself off even before God starts writing your own story. You understand? Before God starts doing certain things for you. If you look at your life, if you look back and you wonder, you check. If you want to begin to list the things God has done for you, some of you, I don't know, jotters will not be enough to write and pour out your heart of what God has done for you. As so many of us, we are not supposed to be where we are today. We should have been dead and gone. We should have been somewhere else in the mortuary, maybe crying. Or they would have, you know, people, our family members or whoever, our loved ones may have cried over us and they've gotten over us. But we are here today. 2020 is precisely, this is the 24th of January 2020. So why wouldn't you be grateful? You shouldn't write yourself off. God is yet to start something with you. Why not start appreciating God for the things you are yet to see? Start appreciating God for the things that you know he's going to do for you. Start appreciating God because, yes, he's going to do great things. That way, the enemy who is coming to give you that thought or that mindset that, yes, yours is over, you will run away, because you have awoken the thing that provokes God to do something great for you. So I'm encouraging anyone out there, do not give up. Don't write yourself off. Be thankful for the things God has done. Be thankful for the things God is doing. And be thankful for the things God is yet to do. Be thankful for the future you don't see. What is faith? The evidence of things hoped for and the substance of things not yet seen. Be thankful, be thankful, be thankful, be grateful for the things that you have not yet seen. And believe it in your heart that, yes, God is not yet done with me. Don't write yourself off. Don't give up on yourself. Don't take your own life. Don't do anything that is funny, because God is not yet done with you. God bless you. Amen. Bye.